So the question was, will I get the old film look by using an old lens? No. The lens doesn't have that much power, you know, it's a bunch of glass. The old film look was because of the color profile of particular film. It was the film that was giving the particular look. And each film had a different color profile. They were designed as such, you know, for different needs. For example, the Agfa Optima, the Agfa Ultra, which were my favorite films for a while when I was in Greece. If you use an old lens, here's what you're going to get. You're going to get your sensor firmware colors, same as you were always done, but with problems. A boatload of chromatic aberrations, field curvature, nasty sides, because most of the old lenses are not quite telecentric. Okay, and back in the days, the all these films were using the standard developing process C41 in commercial labs, which was designed for the general public. Artistic explorations were a different thing in the developing process. You see, the old lenses are not telecentric because there was no need to be telecentric on film. The side rays are falling on an angle. So they, in modern sensors which have a high pixel density, they're gonna hit the little micro lens on top of the sensor, because your sensor has micro lenses on it. It's gonna hit the red color filter, and it's gonna end up on the green photodiode. Absolutely certain. And it's going to affect a big part of each side, not just only the edges. And you get an effect that's called color spillover. And it's nasty. And you're gonna convince yourself that this is a retro look, and it's not. You're gonna convince yourself that your lens is an attractive look, but nobody else other than you will like it. Now, you may say, I look at old pictures and they look so attractive. The reason is that most of the films were made to render color, the color of the skin accurately, and in a rather complementing way. You know, it was kind of attractive, the skin tones were attractive, so that made the image look more attractive, but it was not entirely realistic. So here you got the skin tones right, but have you ever seen a tree with this color? You know, you gotta start paying attention to the details, okay, because this is a slightly yellowish photo, and you can realize it by the overall yellowish tint over here. So how do you get a retro look today? Well, in the past, the look was determined by the film and the development process. Today, the look is determined by the film, which is the sensor, and the development process, which is firmware, ISO gain, RAW developer, like your Photoshop or a Lightroom, and filters that you put in Lightroom, let's say Nick's collection, and you give it any look you can imagine, and you have unlimited combinations. So you guys remember this test, I think, the Gerlitz Orrestor 135 versus the Nikon 135 AIS, the manual lens, versus the Zeiss Milvus 135. Now, do you see any retro look in any of those compared to the Milvus, which is a more modern lens? No. After careful examination of the images, the only thing that the only conclusion was that the Milvus 135 was sharper and had less chromatic aberrations than the other two. In particular, though, a good surprise was the Nikon 135, which was very close to the Zeiss, versus the Gerlitz Orrestor, the old lens, which was the worst of the three. Okay, now on the Nikon DA10. So, now the thing is that one advantage of the Gerlitz was that it had a boatload of aperture blades, and that would be great for a night bokeh. Another thing I noticed was that the Nikon 35 AIS was giving a little deeper depth of field, you see that here, than the other two, both the Zeiss and the Gerlitz. I said to myself, so that's a nice travel lens. It's the smallest of the group. It's very easy to handle, and it's got and gives a little deeper depth of field at the same aperture. What more do you want for a travel lens, right? But we have to make some distinctions here, because some would say, why are some old lenses so expensive on eBay then? Is it because they render something magical? No, the magic of 99% of photography today is done on Photoshop. For example, the Voigtlander 125 APO had a retail price at its day of $450. Now it's selling for $2,000. The particular lens, I have to admit, is worth more than $450 because it's an apochromatic lens, very, very nice rendering lens. And in today's world, perhaps it would cost $800 or $1,000, but not $2,000. And it costs $2,000 because it's out of production for many years now, you know, but I do not consider this lens old, because it's corrected for chromatic aberrations and it's quite telecentric. I do not consider the Zeiss 135 Zonar an old lens. It's a current lens, it's an excellent lens. It's a current manual lens and it's excellent. It's actually better in pure performance than the Voigtlander 125 and it's far cheaper. Okay, now let's talk about really old lenses, or lenses that were never great or never corrected. Why are they selling so expensive on eBay? Well, because there are a lot of suckers out there who will buy a crappy piece of furniture for $3,000. Now, I'm not saying go buy Chinese furniture that smells formaldehyde and it's going to poison you. No, but there is handmade furniture out there that is not brand name and it's not Victorian style and it's not old and it's far more sturdy and it's pure wood and does not contain chemicals and costs about $400-$500, not $3,000. Okay, and there are also collectors out there who see themselves in the future on Antiques Roadshow showing an old 50s lens, you know, but they will be outbid by the other guy who has an even older lens, or the other guy who has a rare Leica lens or something like that. In conclusion, some old lenses are good, but you have to test them first and check the images carefully for all that stuff. In general, I would go with apochromatic lenses and also read the lot of reviews and tests before making any purchase, and then check the glass carefully, dust, hazing, fungus, aperture blades. I will not expect any retro look from glass, this is fucking stupid. The look of your image is determined by the sensor and the firmware. Okay, a different glass is not gonna give you a retro look. Now, many people, what they're getting is tint. They're actually getting a defect of the lens. Let's say the lens gives some green tint or some yellow tint or some blue tint because it's not designed for modern cameras. And they call that a retro look, a deformed picture. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Now, to get a retro look, get some filters for Photoshop. That's what you do. Okay, that's what people used to do in the old days. They will change the developing process. Now, generally speaking, if I buy an old lens, I will buy it because it's smaller. It doesn't have autofocus VR computers inside the lens to make it big and heavy. Thanks a lot. Bye.